From the 34th Chaos Communication Congress in Leipzig.
34th Chaos Communication Congress.
So, good morning, everyone, on day 4 of 34C3. And we're getting started right away. Here's Leander Seigel on stage, and he'll be talking about International Image Interoperability Framework, how cultural institutions can create an interoperable framework for digitalized works of art. Give it up for Leander.
Vielen Dank.
Thanks a lot. Also, from my side, good morning, everyone. And I'm really happy that even though this is day 4 of the Congress, all of you showed up for this first talk today. So thank you very much for being here. And I'm really glad to have the opportunity to present this favorite technology of mine, the International Image Interoperability Framework, that allows us to create interoperable exchange points for digitalized cultural works. About myself, I work at the University Library of Leipzig and in the Department for Digital Services, and so that is my background, how I get to deal with these things on a daily basis, but it's also a private passion of mine, and so I have a few private side projects going on in that area. So I think it's well known, and many would agree with me, that digitalized images are a fundamental part of our cultural heritage. For example, scriptures, paintings, manuscripts, there's more access being made available through this. It was restricted in earlier years, but now it's access is provided to lots of people. And so far, digitalization was connected to, meant that the metadata, the images themselves, were kept in closed off systems, weren't there wasn't any possibility to connect them to other data, and so that meant the data was also saved in a way that it was only possible to work with a certain system to present the data. And so this is an example from a couple of years back. This was very modern back then, but today this isn't what we're looking for at all, and it doesn't meet our demands. And so how this will look like, I'm going to talk about that soon. So here, an example of the situation that we were confronted with in the last few years, and it's still that way. Isolated systems, they have their different characters, and they're accessible from repositories, but there's no interoperability between them. And so that is where the International Image Interoperability Framework comes in. So this built upon, built a spec, an API between the repositories themselves, where digitalized images and metadata is located. And these APIs were connected with the presentation, the front-end layer, so that not even bound by certain institutions, all these workspaces could be flew together by the user, so it was up to the user. And this came out of a community from the Stanford University libraries, the British Library, the libraries at Oxford. And this community has really grown quite a lot. For example, the Bavarian State Library is very much involved. Our library here in Leipzig and one in France as well. And so it's a lot of very renowned international libraries are participating in this. Even the Vatican Library, they also provide their digitalized works of art in this interoperable framework. So there's four APIs right now that are licensed under CC BY license. Two of them are necessary to enable a presentation, the image API that delivers the pixels themselves, and the presentation API that provides the structure and metadata for these pixels and makes them available in an interoperable way. Other APIs are concerned with search and authentication, but I'm not going to talk about it more. And so what's nice about this is that it is built on Canvas data. The data is stored in a JSON format. And
in der Regel HTTP URIs, die also auflösbar
sind, und identifiers are usually HTTP URIs,
ermöglichen völlig unabhängig von ihrer Speicherung.
So that allows us to link different sources no matter how they're saved. A few words on the presentation API. The hierarchy is modeled here. We have the collection that creates, that bundles multiple works to a reasonable collection. So researchers can create their own collections. And then we have a manifest file. So this a manifest file means it defines a work as a series of images, and then we have the canvas, and that can be annotated using images or text. So for example, on this slide you can see that this abstract canvas object is annotated with the original image content. And so this allows us to fill this canvas object with different images, with different context, with different annotations. And so these manifest files are structured in this way, as you can see on the slide. Don't have to look at all the details, it just gives you a rough idea of how the internal structure works. And in the same way, the annotations that the users themselves can create within this framework, they're structured the same way. And so it's possible to create annotations for in my own system for objects that aren't even necessarily available within my own system, but in some other institutions. And again, this is represented here using this IIIF. We can combine images from different repositories and collect them into a single unified research environment, which is a nice term, I think. And then save our scientific research results.
Für die APIs von IIIF gibt es zahlreiche Softwareanwendungen. Ich greife hier immer nur ein Beispiel raus, das ich auch gleich noch live zeigen werde.
Right now.
Für die Presentation API gibt es einige Viewer, die die Digitalisate darstellen können.
We can digitally present some examples for this API.
Fähig ist also aus verschiedenen Quellen verschiedene.
And these things actually are combined from different data sources that are then shown together.
Und auch über umfangreiche Funktionen der Bildmanipulation.
And then we see the function of how this application of the pictures combining together.
Bilder ausliefert ist sehr dynamisch.
It's a dynamically structured combination of pictures.
Tatsächlich sagen, welchen Ausschnitt aus einem Bild.
Here we're looking at which section of the picture is actually taken and is it rotated at all?
Auch erbitten, der die Digitalisate dann entsprechend aufbereitet und so.
We can then call and request certain information from the server and then have certain things presented back to us.
Dynamisch auch, in seine eigenen Anwendungen zu.
It's dynamic for every application that we're using.
Wie auch bei der Presentation API gibt es eine ganze Reihe von Softwareprodukten.
For our Presentation API, we have a range of different applications.
Als Beispiel nenne ich hier den IP Image Server.
This is an IP Image Server we're using now as an example.
Apache, das unter der GPL V3.
And we're using Apache under the hood.
Ist eben in der Lage, diese Presentation API zu umzusetzen und das tut er auf der Grundlage
Bilddateien based upon the picture data
die mehrere Auflösungen
there's different resolutions for the different sections of the pictures and then it is then resolved and displayed dynamically
Auswahl an Software mit der man solche Dateien zurzeit erstellen kann. TIFF,
there's different types. There's TIFFs that's usually used. JPEG 2000 is actually a little bit more difficult. The OpenJPEG implementation should improve with this context.
Beispiel Nummer eins, der
Papyrus. The first example we have is this papyrus from Ebers. It's from Egypt.
Der Papyrus Ebers ist eine Schriftrolle.
It's a paper scroll that's over 3,500 years old.
880 medizinische Behandlungen.
Has about 880 medical treatments written on it.
Die Rolle hat eine Gesamtlänge von 18 Metern.
The roll has a length of 18 meters, over 18 meters. And it's now digitalized.
Auf dieser auf unserer Seite und ist auch per IIIF abrufbar natürlich.
So this is yet this is now callable. We can now call this to be loaded and we can look at the quality of this is very good and then we can zoom out to see the entire thing at once.
Das Digitalisat hat übrigens ist 145.000 Pixel breit.
Hier 3,000 pixels high gives you an idea of how large this document is.
Auch die
and it has different functionalities on top of it. So we can look at the translation that's loaded over it.
Medizinischen Verfahren für welche Gebrechen.
We can look at which medical treatments would then be prescribed for different conditions. And now we're skipping over some slides. This is our second example for the codex.
Die gilt als die erste Bibelhandschrift, die das vollständige Neue Testament.
This is the first full New Testament manuscript.
Einrichtungen verteilt. Der größte Teil liegt in der British Library in London.
It was actually separated. The first section was in England, the second in Leipzig, the third in Russia, and also one in Egypt. So this is actually a perfect use case to look at because this document is separated from each other. So we need to then actually combine them to see the work in its original entirety.
Toppen kann man die ganze Sache allerdings noch dadurch, dass es eine zweite Bibelhandschrift gibt, die.
Here's a second picture of some handwriting.
Wie der Name schon sagt, im Vatikan.
And this was actually sitting right now in the Vatican.
Die Leipziger Blätter des Codex Sinaiticus bei uns als IIIF bereitstellen und die.
And then there's also some in Leipzig.
Blätter des Vatikans auch von den Vatikanischen Bibliotheken.
It's in the Vatican Library.
Als IIIF.
Under our framework right now. So now we're going into a demo.
And I'm going to show you how it's possible to use a IIIF compatible layer that you can create yourself and then use various digitalized works from various institutions. I'm going to use the Codex Sinaiticus from Leipzig, and I'm also gonna load the manifest from the Codex Vaticanus into this layer. And now I have this viewer, and so now it's very easy for me to have these works next to each other. And using this example,
individuell in meiner Forschungsumgebung zusammenstellen.
I can pick whatever works I want. So, for example, if we look at the same content, the start of the Book of Esther, and I, as a layman, don't know much about this, but it's you can see that it's the same content, the same words. So moving on, again a representation of how this works, looking at digitalized works from different repositories being loaded at the same time. Example number three is a demo from Project Mirador. Here we can see a manuscript from France. And apparently this happened quite a lot. An illustration was cut out of it. And today, this illustration is in another institution's repository. And so now, using this IIIF model, we can combine different digitalized works on the same canvas. So now we can recreate the original impression using these digital tools. And since this is such a nice system, I can show you how annotations work now. So we can define a certain area and then enter our text, important notice. And depending on how the viewer system is configured, this annotation gets saved locally, but it will be possible in the future to have a work environment for researchers to deposit their annotations in some central system. Here another look into the manifest file. Here we can see that the URL is loaded from different image servers. Those two images get combined on the canvas layer. So another example We have this technology tested in the real world. At the University Library of Leipzig, there's a handwriting course every year, and so we provided a work environment for the participants in which they could use our own manuscripts, but also manuscripts from other institutions, and annotate these manuscripts working together, and so document their research results together. And this was provided by Stanford University Library using this Mirador system that I've talked about already. And as I've said in the beginning, I want to talk about a little private project of mine using Wikidata and the SparkQL endpoint. I loaded images of caps onto my own server, changed the format to IIIF, and made it available for the public and searchable. And so now in this system, you can pick the digital works. And now I can also show you the drag and drop feature that is recommended for implementing the discovery system with presentation systems.
Abrufbar macht und über dieses Logo sind auch die IIIF Manifestdateien, die man benötigt, um die Daten in andere Workspaces zu ziehen.
And here, through this system, you can also reach the IIIF manifest files to use these images in different contexts. And so, another interesting fact, a lot of institutions have used the IIIF system to provide digital content online, for example, the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York, another institution in France, and also one in Switzerland. And they have this project called eCodices. And you know, you can look at the PDF presentation later and get the URLs from there. Archive.org also supports us, supports the standard by now. So this to give you an example of huge data pools that you can tap to fill your presentations or your projects. So this these IIIF APIs are constantly being developed further. There's going to be a switch of the data models for different annotation possibilities, and we also want to support video data. Looking at the institutional side of things, the University Library of Leipzig passed the open digitalization policy. So most of the digitalized works, we want to publish them under CC0 or CCPD mark licenses, and also IIIF compatible. And so if you go on this URL, you can look into our digitalization workspace and see what is being digitalized live. One more remark, we're going to have a hackathon soon in Leipzig where we will also host a IIIF workshop. Thank you very much for your attention. If you want to learn more about IIIF, then you can check that out at IIIF.io. And here's my contact information. And if there's any questions, you know, we still have some minutes left. Applause.
Vielen herzlichen Dank, Leander. Wir haben 5 Minuten für Q&A. Das heißt, wenn ihr Fragen habt, stellt euch das an. Frage an den Signal Angel. Ist das Internet schon munter und hat Fragen? Keine Fragen aus dem Internet. Dann fangen wir bitte mit Mikrofon 1 an.
Guten Morgen.
Good morning.
Vielen Dank für den Vortrag.
Thank you very much for the presentation.
Eine Frage, gibt es Schnittstellen zu Inventur- oder Inventardatenbanken wie StarText, HIDA?
My question then is about the database. What text is there exactly?
Speziell dieses Produkt, da kann ich keine aus.
So this product, I can't say anything about that, but I believe IIIF is a well, it's just the description of a standard framework. And so systems would have to provide access points to realize the standard.
Meine Frage ist, das ist ja jetzt ein Standard.
My question is, there's now a standard. Are there alternative standards?
Der große Vorteil ist ja,
dass wir das alle verwenden. The big advantage here is that everything you can alter it, you can apply it. But what about if Berlin uses a different standard, for instance?
Wird es irgendwie allgemein verwendet in der Bibliothek?
And then how do you then in common apply all of these different standards?
Es gibt tatsächlich einen älteren konkurrierenden.
Yeah, there's an older standard. Based on XML files.
Ist auch vorgesehen, dass die Daten in der Regel als komplette Bilder ausgeliefert
in which data is supposed to be delivered as whole images, but the technological standard we provide layered images, and that's really we're one of a kind there.
Sonst noch Fragen? Hat sich das Internet mittlerweile...
Any more questions?
Die schlafen alle noch.
No.
Haben die auch Party gemacht, so wie wir alle.
Gut, everybody's still tired.
Sonst niemand mehr, dann würde ich sagen, vielen herzlichen Dank.
All right, Leander. So, thank you very much, Leander.
Thank you for listening to the interoperability... We'll be right back.